Strangely enough, there are two jagged boulders which look really misplaced because everything is trees, and then all of a sudden you've got these stupid boulders sitting there.
And he could be found
near He's there. Near the boulders.
Is he still with us?
No.
Well, that was famous alleged psychic Sylvia Browne on the Montel Williams show in 2003, 4 months after Sean Hornbeck disappeared. She said that Sean Hornbeck was dead. She was wrong about that. She said a Hispanic man with dreadlocks had taken him. She was wrong. And she told Sean's grieving parents where to search for his body. She, of course, was wrong about that as well. As you know, Sean was found alive, not stuck between jagged boulders, but in an apartment in suburban St. Louis. Mr. Browne's, or I should say Ms. Browne's mistakes does not end there, and it doesn't surprise famed debunker of the paranormal, James Randi, who also runs an educational foundation. He joins us now. James, thanks for being with us. What is your opinion regarding what we just saw happen with Sylvia Browne on the Montel Williams show? Does it surprise you?
No, I'm not surprised at all, because all of these people who say that they can speak with the dead, all of them, including Sylvia Browne, of course, are like vultures. They sit in a tree and they wait for the grieving to come by. Grieving people who are vulnerable and really need some help and are naive enough to think that if she appears on Montel Williams, Montel Williams wouldn't deceive us, of course. She must be the real thing, and that's not necessarily true. And they jump on these people and charge, as Sylvia does, $700 for a 20-minute reading over the telephone. Incredible, but they believe it.
Well, that's I talked to the Akers yesterday, and they told me that they were only allowed to speak with Sylvia Browne on the show, not before or after. And they were told after the show that if they wanted further communication with her, they would have to pay her going rate, which I thought was $700 for an hour. But you're saying $700 for 20 minutes, and that's a phone consultation. She denies that. Her manager told us she's never charged at all.
Well, I think that's a matter of her opinion against mine.
What do you think it is that makes people go back to a person like Sylvia Browne, even though she was wrong about this case and, as we've shown earlier, wrong about a bunch of others?
Well, she'll be back on Montel Williams or Larry King or some other place again, and that adds to the illusion that she is dependable. Now, I have a collection, Anderson, of all kinds of tapes that have been made of the 20-minute session that she charges $700 for over the telephone. And invariably, every one of the people who sent me those tapes wanted their money back and were totally dissatisfied with it. Most of the tape consists, first of all, of giving the names of these people's guardian angels. That's not what they're looking for. They're not looking for names of other beings that they were in other dimensions in previous ages, millions of years ago. No, they want information that they have questions, burning questions, to which they want answers. And that's not what she answers for them.
And you say that what a lot of these so-called psychics do are cold readings. What's that?
Well, a cold reading is a technique, a specific technique, where you just throw out ideas and initials, things like there's something red connected with this. It's like a right color. It might be a roof of some kind. And the letter M, or maybe a double letter R, I'm not sure. But there's also something about late at night. And I smell gasoline or turpentine, something like that. And electricity is flowing. And they go on and on like this, and they'll fill a tape with this sort of nonsense. And afterwards, if the victims are gullible enough, what they'll do is they'll look back through the tape to find some sort of correlation with what she said.
So-called psychics will say, well, look, even though something can't be scientifically proven, doesn't mean that it's not real or doesn't exist. Do you hold out the possibility that someone could have psychic powers?
Well, we've been offering at the James Randi Educational Foundation a $1 million prize now for many, many years. And Sylvia Browne agreed on international television that she would take the challenge. Then she announced immediately that she didn't know how to reach me. A psychic? Didn't know how to reach me? She can't use the telephone book? And then she said, after we told her how she could reach me, so she wasn't inconvenienced, of course, she then said that I'm not a godly man, so she wouldn't have anything to do with me. Now, wouldn't she want to take that $1 million, which she could earn inside of 50 minutes or so? We figured that's how long it would take to do a definitive test. Mm.
Well, we'll see if she responds now. James Randi, appreciate it. Thanks very much. And we should point out, we invited Sylvia Browne to appear on this program. We keep the invitation open anytime she wants to come on and explain herself, explain why she said that Sean Hornby was dead. The incredible rescue of Ben Ownby and Sean Hornby has raised a lot of questions about missing kids and the people who take them. We'll look at that and more in a special hour, Taken, Children Lost and Found, starting 11 p.m. Eastern tonight.